This is John Reed with qualitycoding.org. Let's continue doing test-driven development of our iOS sample app. Actually, we have two versions, one in Swift and this one in Objective-C. As you can see, we're calling to get a data task, and we have a completion handler that's logging the data. And here's the actual data that comes back from the Marvel API. Now, I think we're ready to start developing the JSON parser of our app, converting this into our response model. But how do we do that? Here's how not to do that. Do not just take this entire response, copy it, paste it into a parser, and take that, and then stick that into a file, and save this file and read it in from the test. This is not a good idea for unit tests, mainly because the test input is now divorced from the actual test code. It's hard to see what the inputs are without going over and finding the file and opening it and digging around in all this stuff and trying to figure out what's relevant. Most of it is not relevant. Let's instead take just this first portion, which returns a successful status code of 200, and let's develop our response from that. Starting a new test, parse JSON data with code 200. And we want a JSON string, so let's start with an empty string, and I'm going to take what I copied before and paste it in, adding the closing brace. But you'll notice that AppCode did me the favor of taking the quotes and escaping them with backslashes. Isn't that great? This is going to be our JSON. We need to convert this into data. Call it JSON data. And now I want to create an object that doesn't exist yet. At this point, we have a red failure, so that's enough for us to stop and switch over to production code just by creating this new class. There we go. Now back over here, let's take this whole thing and extract it to a variable called the SUT, which stands for System Under Test. Now on the SUT, I can call parse JSON data, to return a response model, like that. Okay, at this point I stop. I'm going to create this class, come back, and create this method. Call this JSON data. It returns nil, which is fine. And now let's use Hamcrest. Say assert that the response code is going to be 200, because that's what we passed in. This doesn't compile, and we can't generate code from it because it's inside of a macro. That's all right. We'll just switch over. Actually, let me make this an NS integer, like that, read-only. There. Now I think we have enough to actually run this first test and see it fail. Nope. What's wrong? Ah, it doesn't know what that is. That's easily fixed with that shortcut. tests are running. And we have a failure, and that's good. That's the first step of test-driven development, is to make a failing test. Now, what's the simplest thing we can do to get this to pass? We need to create the proper type. So let's come here, and I'm going to allocate that type and return one. Okay. And inside of here, actually over in the implementation, back over here, let's create an initializer that uses this as a read-only property. That's good. Let's see if this works. There we go. Now, this is dumb code, but it's working code. It doesn't do anything with the data, but it correctly creates a response model and initializes it with a code of 200. Obviously, we don't want to stop there. Let's take this whole thing, duplicate it, and say, what happens if we get, if we specify code 409 instead, which is what Marvel returns when you have problems? Let's run that. I expect this to fail. Good. Now we need to actually parse this out. So let's take this JSON data and pass it to the serializer. Options, none. Error, null for now. We'll come back to that. I'm going to call it a dictionary and we'll come back to that. If we take the dictionary and get its code, and this will assume is an NS number, and we'll come back to that. I should now be able to take this and its integer value and pipe that in, run our tests, cross my fingers, and it's all good. Great. There are a few things to refactor, nothing here yet. Over in the test code, we've got some duplicate code here. Let's take this SUT and extract it to an instance variable. And take this whole line and put that into our setup. And when you set up, be sure to tear it down. Otherwise, it'll stick around, as I've written about in a blog post about teardown. So now that should all be cool. Good. When you refactor, always start from green and end in green. And let me just for now inline these. It's a bit ugly. Maybe if I go like this, it'll be a little clearer. I'll figure out how I want to format the more complicated JSON later. Now, some comments about the production code. First, there are a number of things that I'm not doing that Swift sort of forces you to do, but in Objective-C, you can get by and wave your hands. We don't need to deal with it. Error condition. What happens if the JSON cannot be serialized? This is possible. You're dealing with input that you cannot control, so you better handle the case where it is not serializing. We'll have more tests to deal with that. What happens if the outer object is not a dictionary? That's also a possibility. What happens if that dictionary does not have a code key? What happens if the type of that code is not a number? Okay? These are all sorts of things that can fail. And we'll build up tests to ensure this, But Swift sort of forces you to do that up front and think about it much harder. In Objective-C, we can wave our hands, but don't stop with waving your hands. Keep going and keep writing more tests, which, as you can see, are very easy to read. Come to qualitycoding.org for more examples of test-driven development for both Objective-C and for Swift.